Every day you receive dozens of emails with important attachments, be it client invoices, contracts, resumes, digital assets, you name it. And every day you open your inbox, you search those emails, you find that attachment, you download it on your system, and then you move it to your Google Drive to organize all those attachments in a much better way. This manual process is not just time consuming, it is error prone as well. You might download the wrong attachment, you might forget to upload the attachment to Google Drive, or even you can lose the track of it completely. And it gets much worse if you are handling these recurring requests, recurring emails every week, maybe from the same client, maybe from the same source, doing the same thing again and again every week. But what if those important attachments lands up in the Google Drive folder automatically sorted, labeled, and ready to go? Today's video is all about automatically saving those important attachments to the Google Drive. I'm going to walk you through a step-by-step process of a very simple workflow where you can have just a single attachment saved. I'll show you the shortcomings of that workflow, and we'll build on top of it to handle all the scenarios of multiple files and save those attachments with a pattern like a file name combined with the subject or anything that you would like to do for better organization or better structure to your Google Drive for those important email attachments. So let's get to the screen share and start building our workflow. Alright, as usual, I'm logged into the cloud instance of my n8n workspace, and you can see what we are going to do as a workflow is automatically save email attachments to Google Drive and notify the team on Discord as well. So what we will do is we would have a trigger note that is listening for all the incoming emails, and then there is an important filter note which is going to check if the email has an attachment or not. Then we have a Google Drive note where we will save the files in a specific folder, and finally we are going to use the Discord note which sends a message to your team. So this is a very simple workflow right now. I'm going to show you some of the shortcomings that will be there and what extra notes that we can add in order to solve or overcome those shortcomings that we would be having with a single attachment. And before we start building, let me show you my Google Drive as well where attachments will go. So I have this My Drive, n8n course material, hands-on labs. This is where I would like to save my attachments. And in my Gmail inbox, I have this email which has one single attachment. So we'll start with one single attachment and then we'll extend the workflow to solve the problem for multiple attachments as well. Let's go back to our workspace and start building. So what we want is a trigger note. So for that, I'm going to use the Gmail trigger. So let's use Gmail on message received. So we are going to use that. So I already have an account configured, but I want to use this one. So this trigger is going to scan my inbox every minute and see if there is any other new email or not. So message received is the event on which it is going to work upon. I'm going to disable this simplify, and I'm going to basically add an option of download attachments. So you have to enable this so that this node can download the attachments which are associated to that email. And I'm going to also have attachment prefix as attachment underscore. I'll leave this as default one. I'm not going to change it. And I'm going to click on fetch test event. It is going to fetch one email that was there at the top of my inbox with a single attachment. So you can see the attachment name is attachment zero. Now let's go back and add the filter node. So over here, I'll say filter. And in the filter, what we want is we want dollar binary, right? And I'll change it to expression, right? And then this must becomes object and exist. So what this filter node is going to do is check for binary data in the input that is coming into it and see if that exists or not. If there is no binary input data, it is going to ignore those emails. So let's rename it to filter emails with attachments. So if I execute now, it is going to give us the record which is kept. Nothing is discarded because it had a binary object called attachment underscore zero. Let me format it. Let me just move it over here. And then the third step is to save this attachment on a specific folder in a Google Drive. So I'm going to basically click on this and search for Google Drive. All right. So we want to upload a file. Click on this. So now my Google Drive account is selected. Resource is file, operation is upload, input data field name is data. However, you can see that it is attachment 0 over here. So we are going to change that to attachment 0. Then we have file name. This is where you can get creative. So in order to fetch the file name from this attachment, we have to do few things. I'm going to come back in this workflow and update the file name as the attachment file name. However, for now, because we are building in a step-by-step approach, let's keep it very simple and test out our first use case, which is more like a hard-coded in nature. So for the file name, I'll just use expression. I'll go back to the JSON and let's have the subject out of it. It's over here. I'll just drag the subject, and with this subject, let's just have a static string for now. Let me say plus, and then we have a static string, first attachment upload. Let me put an underscore as well. So how our file name is structured right now, you can see the preview as well. Subject is coming as FWD colon, which is forward attachment test. And then it starts underscore first attachment upload. So that's the file name right now. I know it is hard coded. We are going to fix it very soon. So stay tuned. So now I'm going to basically select the parent drive, which is my drive. That's fine. And I'm going to select the folder. So I don't want the root folder over here. I want the hands-on lab. So that's what the folder that we selected. This is the hands-on lab. And now the folder is selected. Let's execute this step. All right, so the file should have been uploaded, and you can see that the way we named the file, now that file has been uploaded. If I double click on it, it is showing the GenAI Unplugged logo. Now let's just delete this file for now and let's go back and finish our simple workflow that we had. And we wanted to send a message to our team on Discord once the file upload is complete. I'm going to add a Discord node over here. So let's add Discord node and send message. Okay. And the message should be simple. Credential for Discord bot. I don't want bot token. I want the webhook integration. I already have a webhook integration with one of my workspace. In the message, we can say something like a new important. You might need to add a couple of more nodes over here to set this file names or messaging according to your preferences. But that's like pretty trivial. If you are following this course, you would be able to do that. And I'll leave it as a homework for you. And if you have any doubts or questions around customizing this, you can always message me in the community section or on the YouTube channel. So let's test this out. Execute. So the message should be sent. Success is true. So let's go to our Discord channel and it should come here. All right, a new important attachment has been uploaded to our Google Drive folder. So this was basically the message that we sent. And you can see that I have a previous message as well where attachment saved successfully for the email where I have shown the subject of it. And that you can easily tweak over here. And I can say subject. And I can go back one node over here. Go to JSON and drag this subject and put it over here. And if I execute this step now, again, the message would be sent. A new important attachment has been uploaded to our Google Drive folder. Subject is this. So by this, you can see how you can start fine tuning this. Now let's go back and solve the problem of the single email. So if I zoom out a bit, if we open the Google Drive, you saw that in the input data field name, we have attachment underscore zero. Now, if we go back to the canvas and let me just delete this one so that I have this email attachment, which has like about 8-9 attachments there. Let's fetch this one and see what happens. So let me play this one. Now it is going to fetch one item. Now let's go back and execute this step. It has the attachment and you can see now there are so many attachments or 8-9 attachments that it has outputted. However, you can see that all the names that are there in these attachments follow a pattern of attachment underscore zero, attachment underscore zero, 1, 2, 3, 4, similarly all the way till 8 probably, right? So 9 items are there. So 0 to 8 is 9. So 9 attachments have been downloaded by our trigger node, filtered by our filter node. It has the attachment, so it has kept it. But the problem would start lying over there where Google Drive now does not know how to download or upload the attachment one. And you might be thinking, what am I saying? Every node in n8n would run equal to the number of times the input is. So this Google Drive node should run on each and every attachment. Well, in this case, if you look closely, there is only one item that is being returned by our filter emails attachment, which is more like a JSON. Binary files are associated to that single item. So first, what we can do is we can have a split node to split all these attachments and then input that into our Google Drive node. So let's first do that. Let's go back to the canvas. Disconnect this connection over here. Let me make some space. Now let's add a split out node over here. So in this case, it is one item that is being inputted, but we are interested in the binary end of it. So you can see that all these attachments over here, we want to split these attachments into multiple items so that we can input that to our Google Drive. So here I'll just write $binary and let's execute this. So now you can see that this split out node has outputted 9 attachments. So that's how we split multiple items so that each item can be processed one at a time by rest of our workflows. So now this problem is done. Let's go back and attach it to our Google Drive node. And now that you are understanding of that this Google Drive node should run one by one for each and every attachment and upload it, holds true because now it is receiving 9 items. So this Google Drive node is going to run 9 times and upload each and every attachment. However, let's see what happens when I execute this step. So if I execute it, it is going to upload the attachment one, but then you can see that the item has no binary field attachment underscore zero error is coming. Why? Because we had input data field name as attachment zero and this attachment zero is only for attachment zero. If I go to my hands-on lab folder, you would see only one attachment has been uploaded and rest of the attachments have been skipped because of this particular error. So I'm going to go back and we have to fix this undefined as well because now we have made some changes in our workflow. Let's fix that as well. Let's delete this, go back over here. And in order to fix this data field name problem, what we are going to do is we are going to access the name of these attachments in a dynamic manner. And how do you do that? We'll write a single code expression for it. Let's turn on the expression mode in this field. Let's delete this. Let's start by typing double curly braces. This is going to give us the access to the data. So we are not interested in the JSON data. We are interested in the binary data. So we are going to say $binary over here. And you can see that now I have access to the object which has this attachment key over here. So because this is key and you have already seen in the expressions and built-in functions lesson that there are a lot of functions that are available built-in from n8n or JavaScript libraries. So in this case, we are going to use a built-in function called keys that is going to return the keys of any object. So for that, I'm going to write dot and we'll say keys. And because this keys is returning us an array, so we are going to just pick the first one, which will return us this attachment underscore zero. So if I say first, so now you can see it has returned me a dynamic value of attachment equals to zero. It is not hard coded anymore. So that means every time this node is going to run, whenever the first comes for the first item, this code is going to return attachment underscore zero. For the second one, it is going to return underscore one. If I just expand it and click on this arrow over here, which allows us to browse through or move through these items. So if you click on it, now the first item attachment underscore one is coming. Second attachment underscore two is coming. So that's how you solve the problem of hard coding in case you want to upload multiple files from your Gmail inbox to the Google Drive. So now if I run this code, this is going to execute. However, let's quickly fix the subject part as well. Because this time we are accessing the subject over here. I don't think there is any kind of data in the JSON because we have introduced a split out node. Earlier there was no split out node. So what we have to do is in this subject thing, which was coming as undefined, we have to go back one node. So let's go back to filter email attachments node. And over here, let's go to the JSON where the subject was present. Here, I'll just drag that and put it here. So now this is going to basically have filter emails attachment node dot item dot json dot subject. This is going to return us the subject. Now you can see instead of undefined, the complete subject is coming and first attachment upload, which is the hard-coded name that we have given it to this file that is coming. Now, this is the second problem that we have, that we are specifying the same name for each and every file. So we have to make it dynamic. So let's go ahead and fix that as well, so that you can fetch the file name from the email in your Gmail inbox. So for that, I'll just use underscore over here. So we'll separate the subject and the underscore, and then we would have a file name, just to provide a little structure of it. So over here, we have to fetch the file name. And if we go back to the binary, let's go back to split out node and go back to binary. So the file name is present under the value of this particular item. So you can see the file name is coming for attachment underscore zero. Attachment underscore one also has a file name. So much like what we did with $binary.keys.first, now we are going to access the value of it instead of keys. So much like you have keys as a function which returns you the keys of the item, similarly there is a function called values that returns the values of it. So let's build that expression by first accessing the binary data, which is from $binary. Then we would have values, so that would return us the values. So it is returning as an object right now. Similarly, we'll say .first, right? So the moment I say .first, still it is returning as object, but now we have access to the properties of the first object. So if I click on dot over here, it is going to return me the properties which are there, and you can see that ID is there, file extension, file name, file size, file type, and MIME type. So we can say file extension or file name. I'll just say file name. And now you can see that the file name is coming over here. So unable to renew subscription, that was the subject which was there. Then we have an underscore as a separator between file name and the subject. And then we have this file name which is coming over here, and you can see that it is matching. Now our workflow is complete. If I click on execute step, it is going to upload all the 9 attachments with this subject underscore file name of the original attachment that was there in your email inbox. So it is taking some time. Alright, so you can see all 9 items have been successfully uploaded. Output has success. If we go to our Google Drive, all the 9 attachments you can see have been uploaded successfully over here. And the last step that was pending was basically the Discord message, and I'm going to play this. So if we go to our Discord channel, so you can see 9 messages have been successfully sent over here. Now, how do you combine all these 9 messages into a single update? If you don't know the answer, go and check out my rest of the lessons in the course so far that I have covered. I have already covered this concept in detail, how you can send just one single notification or single email to customer service or anywhere you want to send using nodes such as aggregate node or code node. Now let's go back and give it a final run as well. Let me format it properly, save it first, and we'll clear the execution. So we clear the execution. There is no execution over here. I'll go to my Google Drive and I'll delete all of them. So let's delete all of them. So all these are deleted. Let's refresh this. And what we do, okay, leave this inbox over here as is. Now before I take leave, I'm going to execute this workflow one more time so that everything is working fine and we can see it from here. So you can see Google Drive node is running, taking some time. It is going to upload all the attachments in our Google Drive folder with the specified logic that we have. You can fine tune the way you want to organize it by file name or the names of the folder that you are creating. You might need to add a couple of more n8n nodes in order to do that. You can always follow my channel or the course in order to learn about how you can organize, or if you have any doubt, you can always reach out to me. So the workflow has successfully completed. If we go over here and I refresh it, all the 9 attachments have been successfully uploaded. And how this kind of solution can help you is, well, it will free up your mental space because you no longer need to remember to download and organize these important email attachments. Secondly, it helps you with compliance as well, because those attachments or important attachments are always backed up in a Google Drive. And finally, if you work in a remote collaborative environment where there are team members scattered across the team, these attachments will automatically get uploaded to these Google Drives, which can be shared among the entire team so that they have access to them or these files as soon as they land up in your inbox or a common inbox. So that was it from today's lesson. I wanted to cover in detail how you can simplify this business process or personal process in your life and automate it and save time for yourself. You can always introduce AI into it or some smart logics to make it much more smarter and efficient and make time for yourself.